now we're gonna go into the Banco do Estado de São Paulo. It's actually an art museum, and we're talking 26 floors or so. We're gonna go all the way to the top at the beginning, and there's a sky view, so we're gonna get to see São Paulo from way up. And then start working our way down and checking out some of the art and history of São Paulo, some of the creative, you know, the musicians and a lot of modern art too. So it's going to be kind of a mix, and even a little bit of kind of history of the city and even the banking, the history of the bank. So anyway, this is what we're going to do. Well, here David's my cousin, and we're over at what do you think this is called? The National Bank?
Bank of Brazil.
Yeah. It's actually kind of an art museum, right?
Yeah.
That's basically what it is. But we got this, we're on the 26th floor.
Uh-huh.
And we've got this amazing view of São Paulo. Phenomenal. Looks like there's a storm on the horizon. Like old kind of dilapidated buildings too. You used to see some really interesting ones in Turkey too. Yeah. I bet you guys got some interesting ones. So yeah, I think it was 26 stories up. I think my ears popped on the way up the elevator. Rod right here, I think. There's lightning rods along, or maybe it's to keep the birds away. Some of them, maybe it has to do with keeping the birds away. It looks like there's some plants growing up here too.
See, there are like little mountains here.
Oh yeah, it kind of makes you think of Colorado, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah, the foothills.
Yeah. I remember when you'd get up in there, even to walk, not even to climb anything, just to walk, you'd feel like you're gonna pass out.
Yeah.
The air is so thin. Now you can see the foothills over on this end. Looks like a Celtic symbol on that yellow building. Looks like an owl painted on that thing. A lot of interesting graffiti around here.
Yeah.
So now we went down to the 24th floor to see some photography, and they have an English version of what we're about to see, along with the Portuguese over here. Andre Feliciano. Firefly light. light directly over photographic paper. Hoping to see some abstract, I love this abstract kind of experimental stuff that they do. So the exposure process is a little bit unconventional. These kind of, I don't know, somewhat random sort of results, which is pretty neat. There's a video over on this end. Some different colors going on. Wow.
These are firefly lights.
Yeah, we used to have fireflies in Illinois.
Yeah.
They're pretty beautiful. It'd make that green. Kind of green luminescence. Wild idea. So these are just the video the fireflies themselves. David just pointed out this is actually a negative of the firefly light. So anyway, after you, as you can see the expositio on the 24th floor, so you can tell that those are the art expeditions. See, we go down now to the 23rd floor, so it looks like there's like a few floors, as you can see, where we'll be able to see art. We were at the coffee house, 29th floor, after we got came down from that rough view. So anyway, now we're going to progress down to floor 23, see what's down there. This would be a place, if I was with my band, we'd do a band photo in here. I think there's like 1,000 of you, dude. Look, it's like the Umaguma album cover, if you ever saw it by Pink Floyd. Like, if you see how many.
Oh, yeah.
You go on for eternity.
Yeah.
Just go down the stairs. So we decided to start a higher floor and work our way downward. And, oh wow, David, this is gonna be great. Oh my goodness. I've seen videos of this, but I've never been in one of these kind of things.
That's naturally what. That's weird.
Yeah. love this music too. Reminds me of Steve Roach, some of the electronic ambient type stuff. Yeah. Oh, here. Well, anyway, there's a lot of information here. Flowers bombing. Again, they start with Portuguese, I assume, and we're moving down to the English down here. I was talking to someone upstairs, and she said that she studied art for 4 years and lived in Louisiana, and she mentioned that because I told her that her English is really great, and that was kind of her explanation of why. She was really, really a great person to talk to. Thank you. that maybe when you press your hand on some, that maybe the flowers might appear. I'm not sure if it's just so happens that the video thing's doing that right then, or
nothing.
Or I'll try this spot here and see. This is black right now. Yeah, I'm not sure. I think it might just be a coincidence.
Just the way it is.
Next floor is a skating park. Skateboarders. That's kind of neat. We're on like the 22nd floor or 21st floor now.
Hey. Fala em português? You can see the skate park at the block, and I have a skate shop with a great view of the city.
Hey, cool. Nice little diversion for a bit there. Skateboarding. My friend Alan said that he had just gotten a skateboard. This guy I grew up with.
Really?
Yeah, he got back into it for some reason. Alan's an interesting guy. records.
Yeah.
Vinyl. Oh, wow. The classics, the old Gilberto. That's neat. Classic. That's what's playing right now, obviously. Stan gets us. These are the song lyrics, the lyrics to that song. It says, a mujer, that's a woman. Que pasa? So maybe these are some song lyrics that were original. I think that's kind of cute. This reminds me of something I used to do when I was young. Text kind of creating images. I used to like that kind of poetry. There's a guy named Edward Morgan from Scotland that did some real experimental emergent poems where the words would kind of spread across the page in unusual ways. This is pretty amazing because I don't know this musical style real well, but I'm guessing I'm getting to see like original song lyrics and poems. You know, the actual handwritten lyrics with crossing out different things and some of the edits that they made. It's pretty awesome. So we went from seeing some, you know, real contemporary art to now some of the classics.
Dois meses, aí eu fiz um monte de
Kind of giving you a layout of who are in these pictures and got numbered here. I don't know too many names. I know Catano Veloso and the band Os Mutantes. They're part of something called the Tropicalia movement, so I know a little bit about that, but it's been a long time since I read the book about it, so I don't remember much. I'd have to pull it out again to fully be able to appreciate who these people are, because I suspect that, you know, some of them, if they weren't part of Tropicalia, because that was more, I think, in the 60s and 70s, but a little bit before that, you know, you had all that bossa nova and samba. I assume that these are people that were important in that world, you know, theater and music and film and everything. They're all kind of revolutionizing what could be done in all those areas. And there's some political stuff that was kind of connected to some of it as well.
Yeah, I see a chair out there. I'm gonna go sit down for a little bit.
Okay. Okay, so now we're on another floor. I think we're gonna see some more visual art. I was wondering if this is Frida, but it might not be. Let's see what we have here. So I think, yeah, I think actually when we walked in, Vinicius de Moraes, so I think this is all his art, actually. made like saw some things with dates like 1945, 1970, okay. Yeah, I'm just trying to look for some dates here, just get some kind of idea. It's kind of nice sometimes to see the dates, and some artists have different eras of their career, especially, you know, when I was at the Salvador Dali Museum, definitely drastic changes in his art throughout time. And so I'm guessing that that he probably, you know, there's probably some differences between his work from 1943 versus 1970. There's just so many different things going on. That's really beautiful. I love that. One thing that's neat about going to see art at the museum is sometimes when you're looking at it in a book, you don't get a sense of the paint strokes. It's kind of neat to think you're so close to something physically that these artists created, that, you know, you have access to something like this. Beautiful. Love the colors on this one in particular. It does look like we're seeing the work of a few different artists. We've seen different names in here. Sadly, I'm just not familiar with. I'm just not familiar with who a lot of these people are, but you can obviously get your educate yourself about these things. Of course, it would help to be able to read Portuguese. I'm just not that good. I had 2 weeks to learn. So I apologize if I don't have any great insights into what we're seeing here, but perhaps someone that's watching this is going, oh yeah, I can't believe it, they've got that. The original lyrics from something, or... I love to geek out on things like that. This looks like it'd be cover of a 7-inch record. It's got that size. So neat. Oh, see, this is, I'm guessing based on this classic album cover, reminds me vaguely, not a lot, it's got its own look and feel, but it reminds me just a teeny bit of Mary Blair, the woman that did all that Disney artwork. See a sketch and then it's filled in. Reminds me of that kind of like back in the days of Sketches with Spain by Miles Davis and some of the early those orchestrations that they would do.
I just watched a documentary on Netflix.
Did you? Yeah. Yeah, he wasn't the nicest guy, wasn't the easiest guy to get along with, but he also had a very rough, you know, I mean, he was treated. It must have been weird being him because, you know, you're treated very unevenly. In one place you're worshipped and in another place you're trash.
Yeah,
and he got beat up by the police and stuff.
Yeah, showed that blood all over him.
Then he'd go to Paris and he'd practically worship him. You know, it must have been strange for all those, like, bebop guys and jazz musicians, you know, kind of getting that sort of, like... Something about memories, or weren't you saying that Brazil was like a military state until what year?
Was 1984.
84, yeah. So did they sort of become a democracy then in 84,
sort of.
Or was it some other kind of
no,
thing?
No, it went to democracy.
And do they have like presidents?
Yeah.
Is that how they do it?
Yeah.
And then they have, what do they have, like, below the president, like, we have the House and the Senate. Do they have, like...
They have Congress here. I'm not sure exactly how it works.
Yeah.
And they have, like, a Supreme Court.
Yeah. Right. And are these people, do you think these people are government?
This is the bank. This is where, this is the name of the building. We're in the Banco de
Estado. Oh, the Banco, yeah. So these are bank officials?
I guess so. Not
much to look at. You would think they would be like presidents or something or other. But, I mean, who, you know, I could hardly imagine, like, oh yeah, here's the guy who ran Wells Fargo back in 1932.
I'm so glad that he's pretty much done with Wells Fargo.
Oh, here it says Hall of Presidents, but maybe they're presidents of the bank.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Oh, see, because this building is, like you're saying, it has to do with the bank somehow. 70 years. So these were presidents of the bank. 50 paintings of some of these presidents portrayed in oil on canvas. Yeah, if someone said, oh yeah, you know, here's the Hall of Presidents of Bank of America, that'd be a real snooze fest, I would think. I hate to say it, but I'm sure
I
they did.
The walls.
Yeah, you like the wood, the smell of the wood. These are some more modern presidents, I suppose. It looks neat, but this is not my jam. So these guys are given loans. Well, I guess keeps the world going around, I suppose, huh? So this is one of the old meeting rooms at the bank. Again, try not to get too excited. I know this is like I'm almost gonna pass out from excitement.
The chairs, I guess.
Yeah. So when they say you can take this to the bank, well, here we are. So I was just asking David if he'd like to see my cubicle from when I worked at.
Definitely.
You want to know the Traveler's Years or the Indian Insurance?
All of it.
Liberty Mutual. Yeah, I don't blame you because it's all very exciting. I underwrote commercial lines insurance. And I think that it should be, you know, like when I wrote, I can't even think of anything right now. Well, here's where I signed off on this workers' comp policy. They had a much nicer desk than I had.
Yeah.
And I didn't have like chairs for guests or anything. It's just
leather chairs.
My chairs though were probably very ergonomically sound. You know. You know, I wonder if this is Mr. Potter's desk.
From Wonderful Life.
Yeah, yeah. Maybe this is where he, you know, tried to take over the town. And
sentimental hogwash.
Yeah, yeah. Yes. This is probably about where George Bailey kneeled. Offered up his life insurance policy as collateral.
You're worth more dead than alive. I've seen that show many times.
No, yeah. Me too, man. You know, I was hoping for more banker's desk, but we get more art, you know. Look at this. This is like kind of like pointillism. This kind of reminds me of that one piece. There's one piece at the Dali Museum, and it's when you're up close, you can't see what it is, and then when you walk about 30 feet back, you realize it's Abraham Lincoln. And you can also see, superimposed with that, Gala, his wife, in different parts of it. This is so cool. Cityscape here. The city. Cidade. This reminds me just a little bit, there's a South African artist called William Kentridge that I like a lot. I even got a t-shirt and I got a video about him. But yeah, he did all this cool charcoal type stuff about South Africa, sort of apartheid days. And then I was watching a friend of mine and I went to the theater to see a production of some kind of, I can't remember, some kind of 12-tone opera music. And all of a sudden, I was like, man, the art looks familiar. And it was that same guy, William Kentridge. And I was like, God, I haven't seen his work in like 20 years, you know? It's pretty cool. So this is a 360 view of São Paulo. It's kind of funny, because we're on the roof getting a 360 view.
Yeah,
and now we're getting kind of an artist's depiction of it. We've kind of gone Yes, no pun intended, but we've kind of gone full circle. David just pointed out that this is called Pictures of Junk. And it is interesting because I started walking closer up to this, like this building over here, and I'm like, oh, I've seen a license plate. Kind of parts like you'd find in a garage or something. There's a fire hydrant. That's pretty cool. Wow, telephone.
It's a metro station.
Metro station, yeah. And then this looks like our rehearsal space with all the cords. You got why it's a tripping hazard in rehearsal space because you got all that stuff. You know, you're working in a real small room, so. It's kind of neat too, you got the sounds of traffic and the noises of the city. Yeah, that's what's neat. I love it.
Close. It doesn't look anything like.
Right. Yeah, I love stuff like that where you kind of get different experience based on the perspective that you're looking at it from.
The other is to Sunday in the Park by George.
Yeah.
And it's like that. You got close, you can't tell anything, then you slowly back away.
Nah, that's neat. Wow. One thing I wonder about with this, with all the sounds of traffic and city noise, if some other kind of sounds have been snuck in that you don't realize are there, you know? I didn't realize this is kind of like a time lapse of them creating that piece of art. So you can see them kind of dropping different pieces in. So they probably started maybe with like kind of a regular picture of the city. Photograph or drawing or what, and then they just started popping in some of these elements where they would fit in. Down to like the third floor, and you can kind of get a view here of the, well, you can get a view of the entrance here. This big chandelier. You definitely get your money's worth here. David, do you remember how much it cost to, per ticket? What was it?
35
AIs. So that divide by five about, and we're talking $7. You definitely get your money's worth, I think, over here. It's wonderful.
Well, that about does it for this episode of Roundabout with Dan. Visiting the São Paulo State Bank and Art Museum. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Do hit the subscribe button and the like button, and I always love to hear your comments too. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye-bye.